Number five in the Trick Trike series is here, the Torque Trike. Check out that beauty. We'll bring it up nice and close. 1/25th scale Diamond Dave's design. Beautiful box art on that one. I love the fade color in that, the purple to the thing with the red-orange block, the massive high-rise intake, the leather interior. This is number five in the series. I'm going to get to build all six. The other one is due to be coming out this year. Let's take a look at the parts count that is not high in these kits. We got our nice interior bucket. We got the exterior of that with the side shield. We can get that painted and I will hand paint that leather seat. We got that awesome intake. I can metallicize that quite easy. We've got, I don't know what that is. Is that an old front tire? When they used to just give you the plastic front tire? We've got our V8 with transmission attached, cylinder heads, wheel backs, and the intake for the individual high-rise on some of the models. So that's pretty awesome there. We've got beautifully sculpted and then molded body for this trike. Look at that. That is just smooth with the lines. We got some inlets back here. That's very sharp looking and done in a nice smooth white styrene, which will take paint easily. See the inside there. We got our suspension and our drive line there. So that's pretty cool on those. There's not a lot of parts in these. They're super easy kits to build. We've got a gorgeous chrome tree. Check out those headers on there. Looks like we've got some exhaust outlets. We can blacken in there. We've got a differential, beautiful set of wheels. Long fork. I love that the main fork is assembled and just the sides of the fork have to be glued on, and they include little pins to put them on. That makes your life a lot easier. Customized valve covers, chrome oil pan, all kinds of lights. We got our high-rise intake pieces. I don't think they're used on this kit, so you'll have these extra with that intake left over to use on another model. But of course, it's your motorcycle. It's your trike. You can customize it as you want. I like to build mine as the box art on these, so I won't be using those parts, but they will be in there. We've got a nice set of three tires, Firestone Drag 500s, and on the other side, twin, I don't know if you can get up close enough with the camera, twin Redline tires, slicks. We'll sand those down, they're going to look real mean. We've got a little baby Pirelli on the front end. And I think that's what that styrene tire was. We'll end up using the rubber one. But you can use the styrene if you wish and save this for something else. We got a little bitty metal axle to reinforce the back end. We've got an option of orange, clear, or purple glass on the vehicle. Headlights and rear glass. It's nice to have those on there. And we got a nice, huge decal sheet. We got stripes, we got patterns, we got the Maltese cross with the flames, we got peace emblems, we got more crosses, we got diamonds, flames, we got NHRA decals, we got skull and crossbone, Reaper, all kinds of contingency emblems, lot of stuff on there, massive decal sheet. Nothing but leftovers on there because you couldn't use possibly on one vehicle. And that is everything that's in the little Torque Trike. Small box, few amount of parts, lots of fun. I'm going to get to building mine and be right back. 30 minutes of building, if you could call it that. It's really just putting it together and running glue. It's super easy to work on these kits, and they are such a good time. I've got the engine all set up here. You can see I've got the intake on here. Those risers actually are part of this kit when I looked in the manual. So I'm going to be painting the block and the heads and the intake all a nice color. I'll be individually painting the transmission with, and you already know if you've seen more than one video. Then I'll be attaching the chrome oil pan, the valve covers, and the high-rise intakes after the intakes I'll install after the engine is installed in the trike so that I don't knock any off. But yeah, so that is included on there, and this isn't just the end of the intake. There actually is those high-rise on there. So that's going to be a cool-looking thing that I've got all glued together. The fork, check out how pretty that is. I use super glue and a little bit of activator. If you get any cloudiness when you use super glue, a coat of Future Floor Polish will get rid of it for you. But that's how the fork's going to look. It's really forking nice. Very sharp looking. It is the one main piece and the two side pieces that just glue on with positive mounting locations like I showed you, those little pins. We got the differential. Going to leave that in chrome, just sanded it down a little bit. We'll touch that up with a Molotow pen and use model glue when I sanded the mating surfaces. Same as that front wheel, leaving that chrome. Glued the two halves together by sanding down the interior faces and using model glue and then clamping them together. We've got our interior, our headlight mount, our wheel backs. The rest of this stuff isn't used, but it's still on the tree, so I'm just leaving it there. We're going to be painting that body color. And the main body, you can see how nice that seam is. Now, of course, you can sand this, fill this, if you want to make that perfect. I don't worry about it. I just glue it together, and we get to building. I leave the neck unglued. There is a nice pin that will hold that together at the end. A drop of super glue will bring that right together. And that's so that I can get that fork in there, I can get the engine down in there, and then clip that together. A couple drops of super glue, hold that neck together with a clamp, and we are good to go towards the end. But that is very, I love the shape of that one. And it's a nice size too. I'll be able to clamp on right down there where I'll be painting and get a nice coat of paint on all of it. I'm gonna hit the paint booth right now and I'll see you over there. Thank you. Second up in this video, AMT's 125th scale 1998 Chrysler Concord Snapfast Slammer. It's a completely customized Chrysler Concord. There is no real option for building it as a stock car as is, but some people have accomplished that. It's got some cool graphics in it, a very, very simple build, and that's all I'm going to do this as a nice, quick, simple build. That's why I tossed it in with the Torque Trike 2-for-1 video. Let's look at all the cool little parts that'll be in the box. They give you the full decal sheet to replicate that box art. They are water slide decals. They should go on quite easily. They're all a good size, and we got a nice Street Heat license plate on there. Those are nice and sharp. I love the coloring on those. We got a set of chrome wheels. There are four. One just fell off in the box. I have it. But a nice set of large roller style wheels, the big and littles. We got a beautiful set of four total low profile tires with excellent tread. No name on the side, but the sidewall's so small you wouldn't notice anyways. Excellent tread pattern on those. Those are going to look sweet. We got two steel axles because this will be a roller. You can actually roll it along the floor for the youngsters. We've got some styrene parts. Let's throw them all out here. Do it quick, clean, and neat. We got blacked out windows. You don't have an interior on this car. They are completely black styrene. Some floor polish on there, and that'll look like it's a tinted window, a deep tint on a lowrider. We got that Concord four-door body. I saw these things everywhere. In fact, the only ones I see nowadays are taxis. They have a taxi logo, and they're almost rotted to the ground and burning oil. The cars didn't have a very long life in the real world. So that's the Concord body with that four-door. You can see the door emblems on it and everything. We got the spoiler for the back. That nice, bright, solid yellow plastic. We got our grill here. Headlights molded in. Grill molded in. We can do some detailing on there to bring that stuff out. We got our rear bumper. Exhaust outlets, license plate. These are usually on the real car in the real world, you see these are about here because they backed into 6 or 7 people with it. So that huge plastic bumper is always hanging on an angle. This would be a fun car to kind of beat up. And the chassis is one solid piece. We've got the front wheel drive V6. We've got the catalytic converters coming to the single exhaust, working its way out to the dual outlets. Nice detail on there. You can see there's no detail underneath to worry about. So you can paint this, hand detail all that if you desire. I'm going to get to working on mine, make this a real simple build, and I'll be right back. Thank you. two kits, one video once again. This time, the Torque Trike by MPC and the Snapfast Slammer Street Heat 98 Chrysler Concord from AMT, both 1/25th scale kits, both extremely easy and pleasurable builds. My idea, rainy weekends coming up, order the Concord, order the Torque Trike. I'll put links down below so you can snag yours like I always do. And have the kiddos build this one, mom or dad or both, build the Torque Trike, get them all going together, show them how to lay decals, show them how to use future floor polish to shine it up without paint, show them how to decorate, show them how to paint the taillights and the headlights and everything, show them how to lay decals, then do the glue kit together, or do the glue kit while they're doing the snap kit, or just get both for yourself and have a nice time and enjoy two fun kits. I built the Slammer right out of the box as is with just a little paint work, no modifications or anything. And the Torque Trike built out of the box, modified the decals, did it a different color than the box has. I wanted to see that Rust-Oleum metallic red on the box art. They don't have these rear exhaust pipes on, which are an option. So I put them on there. I thought they kind of look cool with the pipe going into the fiberglass body, then the flames and the pipe coming back out. I guarantee if you ran a small block header through a fiberglass body like that and trapped it underneath there like that, you'd end up having flames on those fenders soon, whether you painted them on or not. Awesome looking with that high rise. I haven't seen this manifold on any of the kits yet. The double headlights, the wheel and tire package is gorgeous, and the fork assembles super easy for being small chrome parts. Got our little shifter and our cockpit. I used the orange glass on the back, and I used the clear headlights in the front. Are you watching to see if that tail touches that tail? I set them up so that they almost do, and you folks could see them go around, and every once in a while they get super close. So, very easy to build. The Concord is an interesting subject. I wouldn't think anyone would ever make a model of one. Yet here we go. I mean, that wasn't an extremely common car. There's hardly any around anymore. And they made an entire model of it in a snap-tight kit that's customized, which is pretty cool. And I also want to do this little tutorial in this video, show you how to lay decals with decal solvent, show you how to do the future floor polish, even though I've done it dozens of times. When I tell you something works the way it works, and I say I just brush it on, I'm not lying to you. It really is as easy as I say. I did the trim around the glass and the pillars and all that stuff with a Sharpie marker just to show you how easy peasy modeling can be. I did not enhance the bottom of this one like I did on the Plymouth. I just left it all black and did a very quick build for the purposes of this video. I loved both kits. I actually have the Cobra number 6 in my hands. It just arrived from round 2. Like these two did a while ago. So I'm going to be building that one up for sure and complete the series of 6 on the show. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build for you. Have fun. And we'll see all of you at the next review.